How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard here, back in the shop. 85 today. I keep giving the temperature. Still a little warm, but you know what? We have a couple of really nice days, so that's pretty nice. I got a couple requests from viewers about one of the tools I had posted on homemadetools.net. You gotta visit that website. There's tons of categories and everything that people have made and write up some forums, and it's really, really interesting site. There's lots of great ideas on there for what people have done in all categories, not just metalworking, not just woodworking type stuff. I mean, sheet metal work. It's a great site. You should visit. Everybody should visit that. Anyway, so I had a couple requests. Like I said, one of the tools, I was wondering how it worked. So I did a demo on it. As soon as I set it down. When you get old, you forget stuff in just seconds. It's amazing. Anyway, this is the tool. I called it a Lathe Tailstock dialing in indicator holder. Where I saw it was Ray Canigula's YouTube channel. Ray's done some really good stuff. You should visit his channel. Anyway, he made this and kind of modeled after a video that Tublicane did. And Tublicane made it with like wood block, I think it was. I can't remember right off the bat. But, and made it real simple in the lathe to dial in his tailstock. So Ray made something a little fancier, but simple. This slides, is adjustable back and forth. Slot in the bolt. Hole for the indicator. And so I got a little Interrapid half thousandths test indicator. And anyway, so that's where I got the idea. So that's why those websites, everybody has some good ideas out there. Anyway, so I'm going to show you how I set it up in the lathe. If you want to use it to dial in your tailstock. And I'll show you how I use it in the mill for larger round stuff. But you could also, it gets down pretty small, so you can actually get in there pretty short. Smaller radius, I should say, small holes. Dial them in also with it. It's a real rigid, in the mill, it's really pretty slick because it's really rigid, especially when you're wanting to reach out for a big circle. And you can make that long as you wanted. This one's like 6 inches. So you can do a 12-inch circle pretty easily with it. Anyway, let me show you. It's black. I blued mine. I just finished bluing that the other day. After I did that piece for Tom Lipton, this came out pretty doggone good. Now, I made this, just real quick, I made this from a bolt. I think it was a 1-inch bolt, and I just turned it down. This is a piece of hot rolled bar, half-inch square bar stock. So, it came out pretty good, except for right there. I have no idea what the deal is with that. It's like a real hard spot in the bolt or something. It's a lot different. But anyway, the rest of it came out beautiful. Won't rust. I'll do a video probably eventually on rust bluing. This takes about 4 or 5 days to do, so to come out really dark and light like that. So anyway, let's watch the demos and enjoy.
Okay, we're over here at the lathe. I've got this tool in here in the chuck, as you can see. I call it tailstock alignment tool. This inspiration to build this was not my design. It's actually Ray Canigula's YouTube channel there. And he used it to tailstock alignment. So that's what I called it. So I built one. But I found a few other uses for it. or at least one other, but you could probably think of some more. But I set it up here on the lathe just to demo it. I got a couple of requests from on the homemadetools.net forum, so I thought I'd just make a video. Anyway, this crossbar here is adjustable, so you can do larger circles, and I'll show a setup on the mill where that's where I used it to set up a larger round piece, but I have a nice demo piece I can do it on. So I put this in the forge jaw. I actually dial indicated the end in, so I'm within a half a thou on the end here. I didn't have to really do that, but I did. It makes it a little bit better, I guess. I get the same reading whether it's 5/1000ths out or not. I still can get the same reading, basically. So anyway, now, so what I did here on the back side, I use a mirror. I set a level on there. I level it up just so I do real good on the 180 thing, right? So I'm right at zero, just so you know. I don't know if I can actually show you that, but I'm gonna try. Well, that's hard to do. Okay. Too hard to do. Anyway, so I'm at zero. I'm going to flip it over 180. Your only real concern is the side-to-side so much. Up and down, yeah, you wouldn't cut perfectly parallel. So side-to-side is really what you're concerned about, so you don't cut a taper. Anyway, so there you go, we're level, and I'm showing 7/1000ths on there, so that's total. So I'm 3.5/1000ths to this side toward me, because that's a positive 7 there. My lathe is old, my lathe has some wear, so it's set, mine is off a little bit. My lathe is level. But because of wear, that's the only thing so far I've been able to figure out, basically. I need to have it off a teeny bit. Maybe the headstock's not exactly perfect, but it's pretty darn close. So I can cut straight, no taper. And I've done test cuts, and I know that's where I need it to be set. And I cut within the 0.5 thousandths over 6-7 inches. So that's pretty good for this old thing. But that's what I use it for on the lathe, basically. Now, if you had a really big piece, you could always chuck it up in a drill chuck, and you could dial indicate around on a face plate. If you wanted to do it that way, you could. But you wouldn't need to. But this is mostly what this is for on the lathe. Is indicating out your tailstock. I use the grounds to a Morris taper number 2 ground center here, and I'm just going around it. That's about all I can show you. I'll move it over to the mill and show you how I've used it on the mill. Over on the mill, I've got it set up in a 3/4 collet. Basically, it's just a big indicator holder, but it's real rigid. It works really well for this sort of thing. So I'm going on ground, indicating the outside of the table here, just as a demo. So I got this one side, so over here, one side, I got this side up set up at zero. We can swing it around, not worrying about getting out of whack, really. I'm -3. So I need to come over an inch and a half. What? About 1.5 thousandths. I was in the frame there. I'm sorry. Let's do this. So I have a zero on the other side. I'm over here. I'm 3/1000ths negative. So So I need to come toward me a thousandth and a half. So I'm negative, yeah. So we'll go a thousandth and a half, should be pretty good. We'll swing back, we can check that. I got right at 1.5 to the minus side again, so that's perfect. And we can check the Y direction. Use the old mirror again. We'll just reset it to 0. It was on 1.5 minus, so I might have really got lucky there. No. So, minus a 7. Move that 3.5. Right there, just probably about 1,000th out. Let's reset that, make it easy. And it's just a back and forth process. I've seen a lot of people do this. It's pretty simple. I don't know how outside round this is, but that's 0 and 0. Moving it, you know, we moved it a little bit, so we'll probably be off a little bit now, so we're 3/4 points, 7, we're about 3/4 of a thou. This is a half thousandth indicator, and I'm 3/4, so we're pretty much basically right on the money. But anyway, that's what I use it for on the mill to sweep larger stuff. Even you can do the smaller stuff, it'll go way in. Let me just show you there. Just slide it in. I mean, you can, you know, you could use it for a lot of different, do holes. I could do the center of the table here if I wanted to. Go in here and sweep that. I don't think I'm too far off. Yeah, 3/4. Thousandths. Let's see, what's that about? Minus a half. Yeah, about half. So the outside's not perfectly concentric with the center. That's a number 3 Morris taper in the center. So I was just doing that as a demo. I wouldn't expect that to be perfectly concentric. But it's close. It's only about 1,000.5 on that one way. So anyway, that's the tool. It easy build. You know, hardest part about it is probably milling that slot. This shank is this I used I think it was a 1-inch bolt, and I just turned it down to 3/4 so it'd be easier to fit and things. Rounded up the head, put a slot, quarter 28 set screw here, 8/32 set screw here, mill the slot, put a hole in for the indicator to fit in. That's about it. Thanks, Ray, for the design. I blued mine. I just did that the other day. I'll do a quick video. I do a rust, what's called rust bluing. Takes a little while to do. Like, can take you a week doing it. But the results are usually extremely good. Just a really nice deep black blue color. Long lasting. I won't worry about that ever showing any rust. Around here it's pretty dry. In the winter it gets a little moist, but other than that, it's pretty good. All right, thanks for watching the demo.